no one here to blame, no one to point the finger. It's just you and me and the rain. It's the black leading the blonde. It's the stuff, it's the stuff of country songs. If God will send his angels, and if God will send a sign, and if God will send his angels, will everything be alright?
Ortega Road, Natart. John Arthur Nathan. Ralph Eugene Nathan. Michael Leo Jimmy Lee
William W. McCarroll.
Did she die?
Ivy M. McCarroll Jr. Warren McCarroll. Michael Joseph McCarroll. William P. McCarroll Jr. James W. Gary Eugene McCaslin. Harold McCaslin Jr. Raymond Louise McChesney III, McLean, Gary Thomas McLean, Harry McLean, James Harry McLean, James Lewis McLean, Kenneth Allen McLean, Michael D. McLean, Richard Aaron McLean, Richard Larry McLean.
For me, when I come here and I get to the wall and see the name, I cry.
Henry McLean.
And I'm glad. I'm not, I guess at first I was kind of ashamed to show that I was crying. You know, men don't cry. Well, this man cries. I remember them, and I want people to know. I'm not going to forget. We die. We die for a purpose. If I have any bitterness, it's with our congressmen and senators at the time. They would not let us win. They tied our hands behind our back. A lot of people don't want to say that, you know, they don't want the truth to be known. When the design for the wall was first came out, I was kind of against it. I guess one of those old-fashioned guys. I'm used to memorials being above ground rather than below ground. And since Vietnam was such an unpopular war, I felt if they put one that was below ground, if they wanted to bury it, they could just back up some trucks there and dump gravel over it, and you just never seen it. But once I went there, I can't find the word. It was awesome, I guess.
Very, very humbling experience to be a part of this. If you get the wall set up and you turn around and look at those names, and how fortunate you are to be here, and like I say, just working with it and being able to take them all over the country, and particularly for the people that haven't had a chance to go to D.C. to see the original wall. Then that's what this is all about.
I didn't watch the news or read a newspaper for a year. And reading about the veterans that have been down here and seeing them, I understand how they feel. I was one of the lucky ones. I didn't lose my husband. He's still here. Got wounded and has a Purple Heart, but he's a lucky one.
To me, all the names here, These are the heroes. I'm a combat wounded veterans, and I'm one of the lucky ones. I'm here. If I can find the right words to say, it's not to get myself to get a pat on the back. It's these guys here. They gave their all.
I just wish some of the brothers and sisters on the wall could be here today to see a little bit of it finally coming full circle, and at least, if not everybody accepted it, at least not being as negative as they used to be about it.
We're just truly grateful that they're finally getting the credit and the recognition that they deserve. I'm very proud of them. I always have been. You know, the fact that what others said didn't matter to us, because we knew they were sent there to do a job. They did it the best they could.
Oh,
That's his body. How you doing?
Daniel, George, William, McDaniel, Gilbert, Ellis, McDaniel.
Right there.
I know, I had just
Jackson
seen it.
John Lewis McDaniel.
Found another name.
John Thomas McDaniel.
One of the men in this
John
division.
Thomas McDaniel.
John not one Lee on his boat.
You tell me.
Kenneth Reed.
These are the Listen Division, and the three men on top there were from my boat crew that got hit.
Jr., John Francis McCabe.
Well, when you look at it, you kind of see the futility of war and just how fragile human life is and how quickly it can be taken away from you. Because I think the average age is about 19 years old on the wall.
Michael Ross McCabe. Owen Fred McCabe.
I'm afraid the majority of public probably don't understand what represented, not just by this wall, but any memorial, be it the World War I, Civil War, World War II, Korea. You don't understand, a lot of people don't understand. They thought, well, maybe we should have gone with some of the guys to Canada and whatnot. But for us, it's duty.
I've been to the wall, the old man said, and his eyes were filled with pain. I walked up and down the panels, then I walked by them all again. The names, there were so many, none of them I knew. But then they all began speaking. Their message I'll share with you. My mother and my father, they begged me not to go. They said there were plenty of others whose families didn't need them so. But I said that I was an American. It wasn't honorable to run. They said, you really don't have to go. You are our only son. Another said, I agree with you. My country called, I came. A shot was fired in a crowd, and my body was back on a plane. Many others spoke to me as I stood in front of the wall. They said the protesters don't matter. We know we gave our all. We were soldiers, sailors, and Marines. We were fighting men and true. We were trained to defend our country, and we died for the red, white, and blue. We didn't give our lives for glory, for fortune, or for fame. We gave them so that others would know how democracy got its name. We died in the name of freedom, in the name of America the free. And now I'd ask you one favor, which you can do for me. Tell them all you've been to the wall that heroes' names are there. They died in the name of the country they loved, America so fair.
A lot of names on this wall happened because one of the things I remember was at one particular briefing, we were told, if we see our enemy, we don't open up on them. We let them open up on us first. No way. No way. I'm happy to say I didn't have to do that. But it was more of a political war than anything else, I think.
Guy Thomas McCauley. Albert Joseph McCauley.
This is a very good turnout. It's like Warren, Ohio has been needing something like this for a long time because they just keep coming. It's just wave after wave of people and been quite a few people out here.
Makes you feel good to see that?
Oh yeah, yeah. Yeah, anytime you get people to come out and showing respect and like I say, honoring those who didn't come back home.
Yeah. Roger Thomas McNutt. Stephen Sherwood McVean, James S. Gaddams, Gerald Jerome McAdams, Thomas Arthur McAdams, Glenn Paul McAdoo, Michael Douglas McAdoo, McAfred, Freddie, James K. McLear.